Oh, hey guys, this is Stas again, as you know. Sorry, you know, today I'm recording my, the video on a cell phone because I smashed my camera into the 24-story building, and I honestly don't remember if it was 24 or 22-story building because I was on something that I don't recall on what, so I'm sorry about that. Today I want to talk about Roger Ebert because, rest in peace, Roger Ebert. He died. Either what, yeah, he died. And he was 70. And it's very, it's pretty sad that the guy actually died because the man deserved everything. And he wrote reviews and people listened to him and he influenced people to, to do stuff like just be filmmaker, be cool and stuff. And I got to Roger Ebert about 7, 8 years ago. I don't really remember exactly when. And I read reviews every single movie I've seen, which is most of the movies a year. the thing about him was, I was not always agreed what he would say because, the guy, he made, Richie Rich, for example. It was 3 stars. He gave it 3 stars, and I did not know why he gave it 3 stars. And I thought about it, and I guess because opinion is really different. And I guess he liked the performance of Macaulay Culkin in that one, because he gave Home Alone 2 stars, so which was interesting. And it's interesting stuff like Jim Jarmusch's Limits of Control. He gave it 1 star. You think about, why the hell would he give that movie 1 star? But then again, Jim Jarmusch is not everyone's cup of tea. The man itself is very mysterious, and there's nothing wrong with that either. It's the idea of filmmaker, artist and everything else. So that's Roger Ebert, and he wrote some books and biography, which is called, gosh, what was his biography called? Oh, Life Itself, Life Itself, Life Itself. Yes, very interesting stuff. How he grew up and the movies. He was virtually lived his life like in movies. I mean, because obviously he's seen so many freaking pictures. You probably haven't seen those, and it's so cool, And you see his top 10 list, and you can pull it off and say, "Oh my God, I haven't seen this movie. Like, I gotta see this." And if he said it's good, oh man, it's good. And it's really amazing. And some people don't like Roger Ebert because, they say, "Oh, some critic, American, whatever, American critic, Nothing to do with America itself, but the idea of just, some critic that, says his opinion speaks out of his ass and just he doesn't do anything. But I disagree, like, entirely. Because Roger Ebert is, he gave, he, it's a, it's just a, he gave a light to everything, to cinema. And, some of the movies that are less known, he gave it a column, he wrote about it, and then people would actually look at it and say, "Oh my God, this movie is so amazing. I haven't seen this movie." Stuff like that. The man is just the man. And he had cancer and he died from thyroid cancer, which he battled for 7 years. It's sad, it's pretty sad, but we all die no matter what, I guess. That's Roger Ebert week today. We talked about Roger Ebert. Next week, I'm not sure what I'm going to talk about, but guys, see you next week. Hopefully, see you next week because unless something happens. But yes. Okay, bye. See you next week.